Well, Wanda, that walk to end Sagging is actually taking place on next Saturday morning. But tonight, organizers are trying to get as many people as they can to join them as they raise awareness about Sagging and eventually back it up with the law.
Me, I always keep mine at right about right here.
19-year-old Quamaine Bradley has been wearing his pants way below the hip and showing off his underwear since he was 14.
I was just trying to look cool for everybody else.
But now that he's in his last year of high school and has a baby, he's vowing to stop sagging and pull his pants up.
How do you think people look at you when you wear your clothes like that?
Oh, like he a thug, he a drug dealer, or he mostly about the streets and all this other stuff.
And you don't want that?
No, ma'am.
2 years ago, a woman organized an unsuccessful petition drive to push for a law to make sagging illegal.
It's bad. It's really bad.
Now, Gwen and Ken Rashid are trying to reignite the movement.
I think these kids have to understand, too, that we love them to death.
They say it's a serious problem in every segment of our community.
I see futures being blown.
Mostly young people, but adults too, wearing their pants so far below the hip, they have to use one hand to hold them up. The Rashids say it's just disrespectful.
The pants were sagging so low, you could see their leg, their thigh, and their underwear, and then they had the shirts off. If someone came into my business or came looking for a job, looking like that, which a lot of them do, I wouldn't hire them.
Right now, they hope just asking young people to do the right thing will start changing behavior. But they're working on an ordinance, and this time when they go to City Hall, they hope for better results.
This time we're going in numbers, and hopefully we can get something done there. Hopefully hundreds of people will join us. And I'm talking about from all segments of the city.
Well, the husband and wife have been working on this campaign to bring an end to the sagging for about 4 months and to get people to pull up their pants. And they have been using rewards, hoping to help change behavior, offering free haircuts, money, even meals to restaurants. Now, the walk that they're having next Saturday morning will take place in the shopping center, or begin in the shopping center of the Food Lion in East Winston. Back to you.